Well, hello there. Starting the tradition of showing off all the other extra drawings I'm doing. This is the character I want to use in a Halloween special, and I used him in a previous Halloween comic I did. And I just called him Nosferatu. Of course, Nosferatu I think just means vampire. There's a more cartoony version right there. I think I'm going to change the name to Radomir, and I'm not going to treat him just like a vampire, because he's not really. He's supposed to be this rat lord. He's like a vampire, as if they were inspired by rats instead of bats. So I'm going to call him an undead rat lord, Radomir. And I've started working on him, but you didn't come here for that. We're doing instead page 14 of Corbeau. Page 14. I think we're near the end, if not the end. I think we might have one extra page after this, or this might indeed be it. So let's go ahead and get it started. Now, this is a rough page. So what you see may not be great. We'll just see. Roughs are not always very impressive. But, you know, think about it this way. If you're a kind of a beginning cartoonist, as I am, I'm a student. You shouldn't feel bad about your roughs, you know. Go ahead and show your rough. Who cares, man? You got to show what you're trying to accomplish. I know people. Some people call these thumbnails, and then some people even get like if you put too much detail in your thumbnails, they're like, that's not a thumbnail. I saw a really interesting Tim McBurney live stream where he was trying to address some people that were telling him his thumbnails weren't thumbnails because they had too much detail, and he's like, look, this is what I put for the client and such. So I don't even know where I fall on this, because I like detailed thumbnails, but my thumbnails also look pretty gross. They're pretty rough. So and this might end up being a full bleed page, so I could just tell you what's going to go on. Let's make a new panel. We're down to like 50% on the second layer. It's gonna have two panels at the top. And I don't know if I like it right in the middle. I might offset that. Maybe I'm gonna offset it to the left or to the right. I just don't know which direction yet. Let's put it over there for right now. I've got to get some more. I think this should be a worm's eye view. If the worm's eye view, I think we put the we're gonna put the horizon line really low. This is like a Stargate kind of thing. It's a dimensional portal gate. In this case, it's like a pylon. They're not meant to be walking through it like the Stargate. But. I'll erase that for right now. We need to show something powering up. And then maybe I want him. Do I want him to go full figure? I'm wondering if that's the way to go. Full figure Cersei, he's pointing at it, and he's like, witness the power of this fully operational dimensional portal. Just like in Star Wars, right? Except it's not a Death Star. And, you know, maybe you were looking up at him. Maybe we do an upshot or something. He's gleeful. He's insane. He's got some stuff here. We can see the doors opening up and this energy crackling out of the thing. And then we see Hora's reaction where she gets mad and she's like, I'm not going to let... She's going to have... She's going to use her supernova attack and then... She basically sort of explodes herself somehow. I'm wondering how I want to do this up here. And then down below, maybe I even make your... So we want this to be epic. If you want it epic, you got to go small. It's the explosion that's going to be big, not her. She's going to be small. And actually, I think we're going to show her just like her energy form shredding to pieces. And then in the background... I think we have to do like a... A nimbus of energy, and we'll even do... focus lines around her. So it's the perfect opportunity to do focus lines. And I don't think we can have anything big in the foreground. Maybe we can. Maybe we can put him... I mean, we can go real big, I guess, right here. And he's like, no! And the whole... This is page 14. Page 15, the whole page is just one big explosion, and we're going to see the tiny air sub in the foreground, but like blasted through, like it's caught up in the explosion, and then we're going to do, and that'll be the end. To be continued, maybe. He should be shielding himself. Whoa! So if he's this big, she's gotta be much smaller. We could just, maybe we have the air sub here. It's important for... readers to understand where they are in the picture. Yeah, maybe he's got his head down. Whoa! Maybe this apparatus needs to be more prominent somewhere. See, I take this guy and I move him off to the side a little bit. Okay, so, I don't know, is there much to it? Maybe, okay, how about this? I think she should be facing the other direction, looking down. I know her line, too. I've got an idea for her line where she says something like, "The Titans have done enough damage to the Earth. I'm not going to let you get away with this." And then she throws down supernova attack. And we're going to see her disintegrating in the silhouette. Now, I have an idea that she survives, but it's really just the gems that survive. But Corbeau won't realize this when he starts out, so. I could even do. Here's another idea. I do want to do one more panel. It's kind of funny. I'm like, oh, we got to do like a whole giant, you know, double page splash. That always doesn't always work that way, though, does it? All right, so let's see if we do this. Small panel at the bottom, like an inset. So, like it's going this way, and then maybe we even have some vertical, or not vertical, horizontal focus lines. Something like that. Maybe it's this hand. I'm gonna look at my hand here. That's obviously not my real lettering. I think that almost kind of works. It almost kind of works. Okay, so. This hand could be here. Yeah, next whole page, big explosion where we see the silhouetted airship getting blasted through time and space, and we see for sure that Aura doesn't make it. or at least get some visual proof of some kind. All right, I'm going to use the same. This is my apparatus. I'm wondering if I should make him bigger. Oop, let's make him uniform. He declares victory for the Ape Legion, but it's premature. It makes me kind of want to rethink whether I was going to have Cersei make it and make him sort of a like a Dr. Smith character from Lost in Space, where he's stuck having to, like, they have to, like, work with, like, he becomes their best scientist, but of course he's also an enemy. That's a good start. Like I said, she's a silhouette, but she's going to be like shredding to pieces. I think that's it. I think that's as far as we need to go on this. Okay, so here's the sequence. All right, after the events of the last page, the battle's taking place in the submarine bay. But Cersei's there, and he's activating his dimensional portal. And he's going to take over the Earth. And it's powering up. Boris says... you know, the Titans caused enough problems for the Earth already. I won't allow this to happen again. She goes supernova. Massive explosion. Boom, boom, boom. And then Aura! And that's where we end the page. And then there will be another page after this that's going to show the explosion going on. And that'll be the end of the Corbeau comic for now. And then we're going to switch on to another comic. I want to do Nosferatu. I got another idea for a character called Drake Nova. Ironic that I'm using that name. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe it's just something that's on my mind. And I got some other I've got a variety of other ideas that I want to be doing. Also, I've still got to do around 5 more pages of fantasy art for TerraQuest. By the way, Kickstarter for TerraQuest is now live. There should be a link. And then finally, there is a new Halloween anthology in the works, just so you know. All right, I will talk to you later. See you later. Bye.